Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip, and I'm so glad to be back. It's been a week hiatus. Anyway, we are watching a match between Tint of Blue and BL, two UGC Steel Highlander teams, and we are on King of the Hill Waste, which is a really exciting map, and I've been promised that this is a really exciting game, so cannot wait to see what happens. Right now, we are watching, backstab on the point. The spy takes down the heavy that is Nasiche, I believe, a spy for Tint of Blue. Of course, right now they are in blue, which I appreciate. And they are taking mid right now, very handily right now. Miles, their medic, has crits, I believe. And he waited too long to pop it and goes down, so drops that, but didn't really drop it, he more exploded it. So, but Blue is able to take mid right there, and the time is ticking away. So we'll see if Red can pull some sort of retaliation. It's just a ton of engineer stuff going up, and Doodir. Oh! Did not know that the engineer with crits was waiting around the corner. That's Gordon Freeman Jr. doing his Papa Proud. Gordon Freeman would probably appreciate that. Anyway, those crits, of course, coming with the Frontier Justice. Watch the Delpo cam. Delpo, sorry about that, as he rocket jumps across the map. Actually, some pretty nice rocket jumps right there. Trying to get some damage down, trying to do anything at this point, and goes for the equalizer kill, not able to get this pesky scout, finally, going down, but actually not to him. Anyway, Blue is pushing up. Oh no, this is their own balcony. Some terminologies, I call this balcony, or blue balcony, and this will be red balcony. Not really, your ideal balcony settings, but it is TF2. I want a really pretty TF2 map someday. That'd be nice. I bet there are some out there. I need to explore more custom maps. Anyway, Delpo finally getting that kill on Opal Gents, the opposing scout, who's been very, very annoying. But Blue is looking very good right now, just holding the point. Half of the time is gone. We'll see if CJ, the sniper, can get anything. Not looking like it. Oh, getting a headshot on the heavy, but I believe he was overhealed. Gordon Freeman again with those crits, getting assist on the pyro, but then also taking it down. No, getting assist. Whatever. You saw it. Gordon Freeman Jr. is really using that Frontier Justice to the best of its ability. Look at that kill right there, taking out Delpo as he was trying to get some height advantage with the little alcove things right here, which have the health pack, which are pretty nice for jumping classes. He does a little taunting in the chat. Lol, Revengineer. I like that. Revengineer. That's pretty good, Gordon Freeman Jr. Or I'll call him Jr. I don't know why I said that in a really weird accent either. Bob. 7777s. Getting a nice kill on CJ's opposing sniper. We'll see if he can get this pyro kill. Really wants it. Not able to do it. Whiffing that shot. This engineer, too, is being a little jerk and not getting into his headshots. And Red is working the time away. About 30 seconds gone, but they have quite a task in front of them if they want to get the rest of this time down. Whereas Blue only has less than a minute left. So we will see if they can do it. We have a little bit of a lull in the action, so we'll go over Red's roster real quick. We see Fnatic is medic, Davey is demo, Doomer is the engineer, Bob we saw is sniper. Looks like action going on a little bit, not so much. Doodir is the heavy. Here comes Delpo bombing in, trying to get a medic kill, not able to do it. So Fnatic managing to stay alive with some dodging right there. This engineer, though, is on him in the sewers. We'll see if he can escape, and it looks like he's just gonna run back to spawn. Not a bad idea. No shame in retreating when you're the medic. Of course, if you're any other class. A little shame. But we saw Opal as scout, PK as spy, and Jolt is pyro for BL. Here is Blue, or Tint of Blue, pushing up with the crits. It's crits on crits action, and ton of damage going down. Looks like Flare, the demo for Blue, is actually getting the best damage down. Let's see if he can take out this demo on him. Cannot do it. Oh, I'm going for the pain train, but not able to get it. Actually, a ton of players went down there for Red. So Blue looking pretty good as they try to take this, defend this point for 15 more seconds. Red actually though pushing on right now, so blue has to get on the point if they want to do anything with this. It is the heavy medic combo, which is going to be difficult, but here comes Delpo coming in trying to get some shots. He fell down. We'll see if he can get back up there, but here come the medic and demo for blue taking down the medic and heavy for red. It looks like they're going to be able to cap, or not cap this, they already have it, they need to defend it. Looks like they're going to be able to do overtime, and there we go. So Tinta Blue takes the first round. And let's go over their roster real quick. We have Delpo, as we see on Soldier. He is top scoring in the server, so some nice work right there. Miles is Medic. Flare is Demo. CJ is Sniping. Snowman is Scout. Limbos is Heavy. Gordon Freeman Jr. is Engineer. BMCS777 is Pyro. And Nasiche is Spy. So we will watch to see if BL can't make a comeback, and, well, not really a comeback if they're only down 1-0, but we'll see if they can't make some sort of move to cap first. Well, actually, it looks like they're gonna be able to do it. Blue taking a lot of casualties right there. Miles was stayed alive, though, however, so they will have that crits about the same time Red does. Oh, Fnatic taking a ton of damage now. Doesn't have the crits right yet. Blue crits coming in on the point, and actually, Flare getting 2Ks in there, but not a ton, and Fnatic is going to escape with that 98% charge. So that Uber, or that crits for Blue, not necessarily doing what they wanted to. That medic is still alive. And they did lose their medic in the process. So Fnatic has a super nice Uber advantage. We'll see where he decides to push out from. From the balcony with the demo, just sending a bunch of crits and doing a ton of damage. Davey is just raining pain down upon the blue team. Does finally go down, but and his team actually taking as many casualties. So although the crits was very impressive, the rest of the team was not able to keep up and stay alive. So blue maintains hold of mid right there. We're going to watch Gordon Freeman and see what he can't do with these crits. Oh, he goes down to backstab from PK, so not going to do anything with those crits. Oh, and he says in chat he had 6 crits lined up. Oh, that's unfortunate. And of course, Frontier Justice will give you crits for any kills or assists you get on your mini sentry or sentry gun. So that's very unfortunate for Gorn Freeman right there. I can associate. But it looks... No, Gordon Freeman is on blue. Sorry about that. Looks like Red is able to take back mid, and times are pretty even right now. I wonder if Jolt saw that spy behind him. Needs to do a little bit more of some spy checking. Maybe I'm surprised he's not paired with his heavy and medic. Usually in Highlander, the Pyro will stay with that heavy medic and try to keep that medic alive as long as possible. But he is right now working the sewers. We'll see if he can't get another kill in there. And probably should retreat. He's got 34 health left, which he does, so not a bad idea. Fnatic is working up that crits. I think I heard a fake crits call or charge. So not a bad idea to psych out the opponent. Need to watch the point, though. There's a scout on them, but Snowman, the scout, goes down. Here's the Uber charge, or the crits charge, for Fnatic. He pops it at the same time a buff banner is going on. Little bit of an overkill right there, but managed to stay alive. Oh, and the spy was right behind him, but did not. Fnatic did not see him, but managed to drop down just in time. Oh, he lost his heavy right there to Delpo. Oh, and then goes down to a backstab from Nasiche. So, not a good crits right there. Speaking of crits, there was a crit that just came in out of nowhere. I'm not sure actually what that was from. Anyway, Red is still holding on to points despite their kind of fail push right there. And KN276 tried to go for a bomb in there, but taken down. A nice shot, he acknowledges in the chat. So Blue, or should I say Tinta Blue, looking very strong right now as they push into the point and manage to take it. They do, however, have 2 minutes left to work down the time, which is going to be very difficult. We'll see if they can do it, though. Watch Delpo just rocket jump in there. We'll see if he can get on his cam. But there we go. He is, rocket jumping all over the place. And of course, Waste is a fun map to be a jumping class because you have all these crates and the balcony. And then you can also pretty much jump from one side of the map to the other in, you know, a few seconds. So we'll stay on his cam and see what he decides to do. He does have to worry about somebody getting in behind him, but he's going to be able to pretty much close down this right choke point, leaving the left choke point, the balcony. Actually, no, he's going to the left balcony choke point. Usually you want to set up your heavy map combo on your demo over here maybe, and then get the rest of the classes to cover right. But it looks like they just have Delpo doing it all, which, you know, not a bad idea, because, you know, he has an unusual, which means he's awesome. That's how TF2 goes, right? That's how you judge players by their hats. Duh. Here comes the crits in, popped on the heavy, and Delpo actually managing to stay alive during this. How is he doing it? The heavy goes down, popped on the demo, but Davey goes down, and Fnatic is down in that interaction. Not a whole lot of people left who push up for red, but they are actually getting some time on it. But watch out, here comes Gordon Freeman. He doesn't have any crits, but he does manage to take down PK with the help of Delpo. So Blue looking very good right now. Only 23 seconds left. Remember, they worked this time down for 2 minutes and 20 seconds. So some excellent work right there, but watch out, here comes Red, they're not done yet, and Bob77's obviously an amazing sniper, because look at that hat. Indeed, we'll see if we can't get his frame or his POV. Peeking through the stairs, that's really tricky. Not able to get anything right there, though. Not helping the lagging heavy in front of him is not helping a lot, but yeah, it looks like Doodeer is AFK, lagging, something not happening, but here comes the crits, and there is no waiting in competitive TF2, so the crits take him down. Blue coming back strong. 2 seconds left, this is definitely going into overtime. Blue is probably going to be able to cap it unless the spy can do some magic. Not going to be able to do magic by himself. Oh! So Blue does cap it. We're in overtime for Red, and counting on the seconds on Blue, we may go into overtime for Blue. And we do indeed. It is double overtime, ladies and gentlemen. The next team to cap will win this. Red has a ton of time on the point, but it needs to be worked down, and they are going to do it. Stacking the point with times 10. Here comes the spy, not able to do it, so there we go. Yes, indeed. Close round. Good round. But it does go to Team BL. So that was pretty crazy. A lot of fun. We're going to watch the Davey roll out right here. Just like I said, getting across the map in one jump. So much fun. Doing a ton of damage to the engineer, but he's doing a nice job just jumping with those. Finally, Gordon Freeman does go down, and his gun goes down as well, so he's not happy about that, because that means he doesn't get his crits, because of course you do get your crits, even if your gun gets kills while you're dead. Flare taking a ton of damage in the sewers, and actually Davey found him out and took him down to some stickies as, not sure how I want to end the rest of that sentence. Anyway, Red caps the point, and pushing forward, being super aggressive right here, trying to shut down that right choke. Just sending this ton of spam right there. The pyro and the demo are interesting. Okay, so now they're pushing up to balcony, which is usually what teams will do after they cap mid. They do have 100%, so they should do something with that. Oh, but here comes the crits, and Fnatic is taken down by Flare's crit stickies. Oh, that's, the tragedy, depending on what side you were on. But that was an excellent crits, excellent execution right there by Flare and his medic. So they are able to come in and take mid. So we're seeing some great use of the crits and demos, on the demos especially. And of course, King of the Hill Waste is just so nice for that. And I keep referring to it as King of the Hill Waste because there is a payload waste, which is definitely not as awesome as King of the Hill Waste. So I'll watch Delpo, I keep wanting to call him Delpho, but there is no H. Doing what he does best, which is patrolling this upper area, getting a jump in there, jumping all around. This medic takes him down. That was a crazy circle right there of Fnatic, and Fnatic does go down. So that's going to be a nice advantage right there for Miles, who has his crits again. So if Blue wants to be aggressive, this is definitely the chance to do it. We'll see if Miles decides to pop on his demo flare again, which I would highly suggest. But he should probably do it fast, because he goes down to a backstab from PK. So drop crits right there. Really too bad. They could have done a lot with that, but it was really aggressive and kind of wiped out the blue team. Not able to do it, though, and red is able to push and take mid right there. Limbos is on his own, not able to defend it. And dead, so we'll get off of his camera. How about that? So BL looking good as they managed to take mid. Fnatic has that crits and popping it immediately right now. Don't even see anybody. There's nobody to kill with that crits. Unfortunate, but that's better than dropping it. Still barely alive. Oh, backstab by Nasa Che. So a nice spy pick right there. And, okay, and 276. I think he got like an air shot there. Of course, the soldier he took down was super hurt already, but some nice work right there. Trying to get the medic kill. Not able to. Miles, 20 health left, and he does have that 100%. So if he... Flare going down. Not going to have that demo to pop that crits on. Still going to have that heavy, which is not a bad idea. And does pop it on the heavy, trying to stay alive, taking a ton of spam. Oh, and Miles goes down. Davy takes him down with some well-placed stickies. He was in this little alcove right here, protected from the fire of the heavy, but able to get that spam in there. So some nice work there by Davy. However, they need to push back onto the point that is blue if they want to get this round victory, is what I was trying to say. Victory, if you will. And watching Delpo there, trying to go for one of his big jumps right there, but not able to do it. So 40 seconds left for red, not a whole lot of time. Even if blue does cap, they have 2 minutes to work down. Of course, we saw them in the first round go from 2 minutes and 20 seconds to the round win, so definitely not inconceivable at this point, but definitely very challenging, especially when you have teams as evenly matched as these guys appear to be. So, Bob Seven's missing that headshot, and I got that on camera. Sorry, Bob. But Blue, there we go, taking mid with only 12 seconds left. We'll see if they can hold it for 2 minutes, which is gonna be tough. They do have this crits, trying to push up. Definitely want to take in the Demo Man here. See if they decide to be aggressive. No, they're really pushing back, but I say once you get the crits, there they go. Demo spam coming in, crits going in everywhere, taking down the soldier right there. Need to get a few more down to get the heavy and the pyro. Not able to do it. There we go. Delpo gets a shot on the heavy. He goes down, but unfortunately they lost their medic in that exchange as well. So Blue, though they keep the point and do a ton of damage, lose their medic, which maybe not the best idea, but Flare is alive, so we'll see how that goes. CJ doing what snipers do best, and that's taking down mini sentries, because they don't move, and it's always a headshot on them. Oh, but getting pressured right here by Boomer. No, that's Doomer. Sorry about that. Doomer just saying, you know what? Stop taking down my sentries. This is man-to-man. Let's battle this out. Only 1 minute left for Blue to hold onto this. Red making a pushback now. Looking pretty strong and aggressive. Blue only has about 4 players up, and all of them are really, really hurt. Just got some respawn, so maybe they can get a defense in here. Here comes a heavy with his medic, able to take down the opposing heavy. Oh, but then he goes down. He was super, super hurt from that interaction. Looks like, though, Miles is going to be able to get back, stay alive. Can Red hold on to this? No, Blue is pushing in here. It's going to be another close one, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on to your seats, and I hope you're wearing adult diapers, because this is intense. Here comes Gordon, or Doomer again, sorry, trying to protect it, not able to do it. 30 seconds left for Blue. If Red manages to cap at all, that means they will win. Miles has this Uber, which could be huge. Pyro spy checking, which is an excellent idea. Miles, why aren't you popping this? He could kind of obliterate Red and all their aggression right here. Probably waiting to save it, though, but I'm very scared for him. Oh, because that's why! Oh, Miles. No words for that, but we are 5 seconds left. Can Blue hold onto it, or will Red make this last push? They are pushing, looking pretty good with their heavy medic, but the heavy goes down. Soldier and soldier actions. Spy. oh my god, there's just so much going on right now. Little tiny carrot of red left, and red comes back. Miles is the only one alive for a tint of blue right now. He is not going to be able to defend it, and this round is definitely going to go to BL, I believe. Yes, indeed. Another double overtime. This is getting ridiculous. But ridiculously awesome. So yeah, we'll watch Davy's rail. Let's see if he goes for the same thing again. Looks like he hasn't quite perfected that jump to get over that last little barricade. Maybe he doesn't want to, though, because that would land him right in front of the opposing demo. Snowman trying to get in on Davy, but not able to do it. Let's watch the point right now. What's going on? Official Ghoster trying to get a stab on the engineer, Gordon Freeman, but Gordon Freeman going down to the heavies. Minigun. PK. Minigun's gonna hide. We'll see what he decides to do. Oh, they know he's there, and he goes down. He could have done some cool action right there, but not able to do it. Who's Camden want to get on? Why not Miles? He's got that 100%, probably going to use it to push onto mid if they're smart. He's also got to pop it soon. Now. He's not popping it, but Flair is doing excellent work taking down. I think he got a 3K in that. That's unbelievable. And Miles is just ice for veins is what I say when medics don't pop it, and I think they should, but able to stay alive. So he's just balls of steel right now, calm, cool, and collected, waiting to use this crits when he thinks it's going to be most advantageous. I still think he's playing it way too long right now, finally popping it on his demo. He thinks there's a scout behind him, and I think there actually is. Actually only getting one kill, Duder going down. Of course, the heavy probably should be worth like three kills. And Miles, staying alive. That was pretty bad. But, of course, staying alive after crits is extremely difficult. Miles able to do it and continuing to push up with his team on blue, on the red balcony right here. Blue is looking very dominant right there. Have a great positioning And their engineer has a little mini sentry gun right there. So looking pretty good, but they have to watch out for their vulnerability, which, of course, is the sewers at this point. Seeing Delpo coming out there flaming, so there's got to be a pyro near there. Gordon Freeman, we'll see if he can get some more Revengineer going on. Doesn't look like, no crits, so sad. Very, very sad. Speaking of sad, Bob77s is also hashtag sad. I'm sorry. Not my fault, but still, I'm sorry. Delpo going down to a body shot from Bob7s, so maybe he's a little bit happier now. But especially a little happier now that his team has capped mid. Oh, NASA gets Dude Deer and then also Bob, so not happy about that. He's back to being hashtag sad. Crits coming on the point. This demo is trying to get the scout with sticky crits. Finally able to take down Snowman. But that's got to be the most difficult thing in the world, trying to take down a scout with stickies. We are kind of close times right now, but as we have seen in the previous rounds, these times really doesn't matter who has, 3 minutes left and who has 30 seconds left. These teams are so evenly matched that they really make it go down to the wire every time. Flair getting some nice stickies in there, taking down Bob, so his team will be able to push without the threat of a sniper, and indeed that's what they're doing. Blue looking very good right here as they cap mid. Scores a times even, but Blue is now working it down a little bit more. They do have crits, or Blue does have crits. I'm wondering if they're going to pop it on Flare, which they seem to like to do. It is. Down goes the heavy. Down goes the demo. We'll see if they can get the medic. The spy is also on the medic, and yes, Fnatic does go down to a backstab, so Flare actually a little late to the party, or not getting the credit there. Ooh, but getting a nice... He did get the pill on the soldier right there, so finally getting some recognition for some nice demo work right there. He did lose his... No, he did not lose medic. His medic, Miles. So Miles, again, staying alive. Thinking of another bad joke, but I won't put you guys through that. Flair finding the little hole right there, trying to take down the demo. Demo on demo action in the sewer is not something you want to be a part of, unless you are Davey, the demo who actually wins. Oh, spy on medic, and his heavy just did not know, is completely oblivious. So PK does get miles. Unfortunate right there. PK is dead ringing? Yes, so. Oh, I was looking at the wrong thing. Anyway. 10 seconds left for blue. Can they hold on to it is the question. And if precedent means anything, it looks probably red is going to come in here and push. And we do go to overtime. Red has the numbers right now. They also have a crit on the point. Should probably pop it. Watch out for Delpo. But Delpo goes down to a mini sentry gun. Nice placement right there from Doomer. So red is going to be able to hold it. They do have to hold it for a minute and 30 seconds. Which is pretty significant when the other team is in overtime. Doomer getting up here, taking down the dispenser and other engineer stuff, trying to do some damage with the mini sentry gun, not going to be able to do a ton right there. And red is just on the point. They know if they give it up at all, they will probably lose the round. Still wrecking that crits, or holding that crits, as Fnatic. I think this probably should have popped it a bit ago, because then they would have had time to work up another crits before the end of the round. Here comes the crits. Oh, and Fnatic is taken down by the crits from Flare and Miles. Short-lived, but those two big crit stickies taking down the medic is huge. We'll see if Blue can't push in. They have a slight player advantage. Of course, that doesn't mean too much in King of the Hill waste, because the players do respond so fast, but they do have a little bit of a way to run. Not sure why Blue isn't pushing right here. They not able to take advantage of that opportunity, and Red is back with position on the point. NASA takes down Fnatic again, though, so Red is going to be without their medic as they try to hold these last 10 seconds. Can they do it is the question. Blue, that is Tinted Blue, does not have their medic either, so everyone is just piling onto the point to see if they can do it. Are we going to have another double overtime? Oh god, I hope so. No, we're not. So there we go. That is the time. And looks like they're only playing to three, so that is GG. Team BL manages to take the win with some crazy, crazy overtime. So, so close. I feel like in that you type of map, it's pretty much a draw or a tie, because those caps are amazing. Anyway, thank you so much to Bob for sending me this match. Very exciting, definitely didn't lie. So thank you, and to all those out there who have scrims or games or matches or Highlander or lobbies or anything like that, go ahead and send the STV demos to me at falafel1066@yahoo.com. Hopefully I will get to casting it, and hopefully you enjoy the stuff. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and have a good day.